teacher, what must I do to inherit eternal life?
Why do you call me good? No one is good except God alone. You know the commandments.
Life does not consist in the abundance of possessions.
By faith, Moses, when he had grown up, refused to be known as the son of Pharaoh's daughter. He chose to be mistreated along with the people of God rather than to enjoy the fleeting pleasures of sin. He regarded disgrace for the sake of Christ as of greater value than the treasures of Egypt, because he was looking ahead to his reward. You still lack one thing. Sell everything you have and give to the poor, and you will have treasure in heaven. For wherever your treasure is, there your heart will be also.
When he heard this, he became very sad, because he was very wealthy.
How hard it is for the rich to enter the kingdom of God. Indeed, it is easier for a camel to go through the eye of a needle than for someone who is rich to enter the kingdom of God. How much better to get wisdom than gold, to get insight rather than silver. He will be a sure foundation of your times, a rich store of salvation and wisdom and knowledge. The fear of the Lord is the key to this treasure.
Good teacher, what must I do to inherit eternal life?
Why do you call me good? No one is good except God alone. You know the commandments.
Life does not consist in the abundance of possessions.
By faith, Moses, when he had grown up, refused to be known as the son of Pharaoh's daughter. He chose to be mistreated along with the people of God rather than to enjoy the fleeting pleasures of sin. He regarded disgrace for the sake of Christ as of greater value than the treasures of Egypt, because he was looking ahead to his reward. You still lack one thing. Sell everything you have and give to the poor, and you will have treasure in heaven. For wherever your treasure is, there your heart will be also.
When he heard this, he became very sad, because he was very wealthy.
How hard it is for the rich to enter the kingdom of God. Indeed, it is easier for a camel to go through the eye of a needle than for someone who is rich to enter the kingdom of God. How much better to get wisdom than gold, to get insight rather than silver. He will be a sure foundation of your times, a rich store of salvation and wisdom and knowledge. The fear of the Lord is the key to this treasure.
Good teacher, what must I do to inherit eternal life?
Why do you call me good? No one is good except God alone. You know the commandments.
Life does not consist in the abundance of possessions.
By faith, Moses, when he had grown up, refused to be known as the son of Pharaoh's daughter. He chose to be mistreated along with the people of God rather than to enjoy the fleeting pleasures of sin. He regarded disgrace for the sake of Christ as of greater value than the treasures of Egypt, because he was looking ahead to his reward. You still lack one thing. Sell everything you have and give to the poor, and you will have treasure in heaven. For wherever your treasure is, there your heart will be also.
When he heard this, he became very sad, because he was very wealthy.
How hard it is for the rich to enter the kingdom of God. Indeed, it is easier for a camel to go through the eye of a needle than for someone who is rich to enter the kingdom of God. How much better to get wisdom than gold, to get insight rather than silver. He will be a sure foundation of your times, a rich store of salvation and wisdom and knowledge. The fear of the Lord is the key to this treasure.
Good teacher, what must I do to inherit eternal life?
Why do you call me good? No one is good except God alone. You know the commandments.
Life does not consist in the abundance of possessions.
By faith, Moses, when he had grown up, refused to be known as the son of Pharaoh's daughter. He chose to be mistreated along with the people of God rather than to enjoy the fleeting pleasures of sin. He regarded disgrace for the sake of Christ as of greater value than the treasures of Egypt, because he was looking ahead to his reward. You stole that one thing. Sell everything you have and give to the poor, and you'll have treasure in heaven. For wherever your treasure is, there your heart will be also. When he heard this, he became very sad, because he was very wealthy. How hard it is for the rich to enter the kingdom of God. Indeed, it is easier for a camel to go through the eye of a needle than for someone who is rich to enter the kingdom of God. How much better to get wisdom than gold, to get insight rather than silver. He will be a sure foundation of your times, a rich store of salvation and wisdom and knowledge. The fear of the Lord is a key to this treasure. Listen, my dear brothers and sisters, has not God chosen those who are poor in the eyes of the world to be rich in faith and to inherit the kingdom he promised those who love him? For you know the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, that though he was rich, yet for your sake he became poor, so that you through his poverty might become rich.
And there are the Lord.